Okay, so I don't know if this video will ever see the light of day, but I am not going to work today because today is a day full of doctor's appointments, so I thought maybe I will do sort of a vlog. I feel like, I've never vlogged before, so this is definitely going to be a first for me. But this is probably the only way that I actually can vlog is on days that I don't work, because obviously I can't have my camera with me at work, or recording anything that I'm doing, things like that. So, today I have my endocrinology appointment, and then I'm hoping that that doesn't take too long, and I'm hoping that I can come back here to the house and get some stuff done and then head to my two cardiology appointments. So I'm a little bit of a nervous wreck. I've had like some stomach stuff going on, and I think it's just nerves. It's just a lot going on all in one day. So we'll see how this goes. I'm excited to take you guys along with me, sort of, because obviously I can't record at doctor's appointments either. But just to kind of take you along and just be a part of it. Okay, so I was able to drop my son off at school. I absolutely love getting to do that because on a regular work day, I can't. So I'm really thankful that I had the extra time to do that today, but now I'm gonna head to my appointment. It's a good hour or so, I can talk. It's a good hour or so away from my house, so it's gonna take a bit of time for me to get there, but I'm hoping it's gonna be a good appointment and uneventful and quick, and hoping I can get back home so I can at least catch up on a couple of things. I will see you guys in a few. So I made it a little bit early to my appointment, which I'm glad I did because this office moved buildings and I just wanted to make sure that I made it to the right location and wasn't like super late. But so I'm going to get ready to go into my doctor's appointment. Before I got in the car earlier, I experienced a little bit of I got a very frustrating message on Instagram, and so this is kind of going to be a rant. I don't know if I'm going to keep this or not, but someone basically attacked is a very strong word, but they made an assumption about me replying to their message via direct message on Instagram, and it was just like, that's not how I roll. You know, it was like they messaged me at 2:00 in the morning, and I didn't answer them till 6:30 between 6:30 and 7:00 in the morning. And because I didn't answer right away, their message was, I bet you're not going to respond. You know, I'm not going to quote exactly what they said, but essentially they said, I bet you're not going to respond because I'm not an influencer. I don't have enough followers. I was like, what? Like, first of all, I would never not answer someone based on their status on social media. I don't do that. And I don't go looking at people's profiles before I answer. But the question that they asked, I felt warranted more of a
more of a substantial answer. Without going into too much detail, it was regarding anxiety. So it also threw me off that they asked a question regarding anxiety, but then didn't even give me a chance to answer and automatically assumed that I'm the type of person that will only answer based on your Instagram status. Sometimes things go to your others folder. I guess if you've never interacted with them before, this one didn't go to my others folder. I just felt it needed more of a answer other than, you know, a typical like heart the message or an emoji. This was like I needed to answer and answer thoroughly or in a better way. I guess the whole point of this is like give people a chance to answer you. And don't make assumptions about their character because you don't get an answer right away. I think that I always work really hard to answer and at least acknowledge every message. Can I get to every message? Absolutely not. But I do try my best, and I would never want to make anyone feel less important because I don't get to their message. So that was it. I don't even know how to close out how I feel about that. It's just, I get some type of way when people make assumptions about someone's character without actually knowing them. And especially when it comes to like social media, I don't think that any one of us is any more important than the next person. We're all just doing our best to navigate it all. So that being said, I'm going into my doctor's appointment now and I'm gonna woosah. There's like a lot of people here. Okay, I gotta go. Okay, so I'm done with appointment number one. What's next? Everything went good with like my thyroid stuff, so I'm really excited about that. It's good. There were some other things that came up in some lab work, but we're gonna follow up with that. I'm trying not to be too concerned about it because honestly, I would just be reacting a little bit too early without all the information. So I think now I need to go get something to eat and help calm my nerves and possibly hit up a TJ Maxx that doesn't get shopped at as much as the one near where I live, and maybe I will finally find my Ray Dunn sugar bowl. We shall see. So I totally just went through like the wrong part of the Chick-fil-A drive-thru and had to go all the way back around. Oh my gosh. I have probably only been to this Chick-fil-A like twice in the almost 8-9 years we've lived here, but we live an hour away from here. So, oh my gosh, this is so typical. So let's see. I heard they're still serving breakfast, so that would be great because I could use breakfast right now. Ooh, this Chick-fil-A has a double drive-thru. Coffee maker is down. They should just close. They should just close for the day. That is not okay.
Thank you for choosing Chick-fil-A. It's Emily. How may I serve you?
Yes, can I have a Chick-fil-A biscuit?
No, it's one Chick-fil-A biscuit?
Yes.
And what else for you?
Actually, can I change that? Can I get the number 2 with the chicken minis?
Yes, ma'am. And just the minis or would you like a meal?
The meal.
And what's the drink?
Orange juice is fine.
Home, gosh, that was a long drive. But I think I have about, oh my gosh, what time is it? I have about 30, 35 minutes before I have to leave for my 2 cardiology appointments this afternoon. But there are some things that I really wanted to get done yesterday evening and before I even left for the day that I just didn't get to. So I'm going to do that. I want to do our bedding, wash our bedding, I should say. I need to update my calendar for February because we finally got my son's track schedule. So I think I'm going to take care of that.
Thank you.
I was able to get the laundry started, my bedding, add my son's track calendar to the monthly view in my calendar. I was laughing as I was filling it out because it's like, as your kids get older, I swear every event is like away and it's so far away. So I'm like looking at this calendar and there are track meets on weeknights at 4 p.m. that are more than an hour away. And I'm just like, how as a parent do you get to these events, especially when you work full time? So it's a struggle. It's frustrating. I wish that they would make more things on the weekends. I don't know. There's like one for all of February on the weekend. And I'm just like, I'm not going to get to go to any of my son's track meets. It's a little bit frustrating. I understand, you know, staff wise, all that stuff, they do it majority during the week, but as a working mom, it can be frustrating. I don't have another word for it. So right now I have some things that I need to get done in the kitchen really quick. And then I'm actually making really good time. I still have 15 minutes before I have to leave the house. So I don't know, maybe this whole like vlogging thing is making me more productive. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get started and start cleaning my kitchen. Like as clean as my kitchen's gonna get. It's actually not too bad. I wiped down the counters. Sorry, you could see there. I cleaned off the coffee bar, put the mail away, all that stuff. I cleaned the stove, sort of. Something burned on it yesterday, and I know it's gonna take probably a little bit longer than I have to actually sit and scrub it, but I at least like wiped down all the other crap off of it. And the dishes are done, and I think I just have to put away those little bit of dishes that are in the rack right there, and then I'm just gonna take the last 10 minutes to actually just sit and relax. Yeah, I need that. Back in the car. I feel like this vlog is like all about me being in the car. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I got a lot done in a really short amount of time, and I'm sweating a little bit because it's a little bit warm. It's 75 degrees outside. Anyway, I got that stuff done. My dogs like went berserk because like the FedEx guy came and he rang the doorbell and they lost their minds. So I got a package. That was cool. I finished my calendar. Kitchen's all clean. Now we're just gonna go knock out this doctor's visit. I finished my orange juice from Chick-fil-A, by the way, that I had earlier. And as I'm finishing it, I realize I'm about to have to get on a treadmill for my stress test. Probably not the best choice. No, not at all. Okay.
Okay, so the sun is coming in like a really weird direction. Obviously, I just shared that I'm at Walmart. I had to grab a couple of things. I am done with my cardiology appointment and everything went well. I do have an ongoing issue, but it's not anything to be like majorly concerned about. It's just something that they're gonna keep an eye on, so that's good. I just wanted to wrap up this vlog. It was fun doing it. I don't know that I am, let me see if I can move my visor. I don't know that I am vlog material, but this was fun and I hope you guys enjoyed it and I hope you enjoyed coming along with me. I hope it wasn't too boring. So, and now there's a lot of people walking around looking at me like I've lost my mind. I don't know how people do this all day or every day or whenever. But thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today. I hope you guys loved this video.